1 week into the month, which is kind of crazy. It's making me realize I need to figure out quite a few things for the holidays still. But I usually find the first week of December very exhausting. I've just wrapped up a holiday shop update, which was a lot of work, like a month or two of hardcore sewing and planning and prepping and all of the stuff that goes into a shop update and then shipping. I started Vlogmas, which is just a whole new routine to sort of get used to, where every night I have to edit, upload, and just do all of that. And Camden's birthday, which is December 4th. So it's usually very hectic this first week. And I think yesterday and today, and probably for the next few days, I will just sort of be recuperating from that and taking it easy a little bit. I was hoping to get up very early today and start my cleaning, but I haven't done that. I did manage to pull out the vacuum, but I have an unexpected errand that kind of came up this morning, so I'm going to run out and get that done so that I can get back and just have the rest of the day not thinking about going anywhere. I've got something to do with Camden on his computer, and I think I want to take out my Christmas notebook that I started last year because I really need to start making some lists. Think about what else I can get crossed off of my holiday shopping list and what we might need to order. Baking lists, meals, all of that kind of stuff. So I think that's what I'm going to do today. I've been getting lots and lots of lovely comments on Vlogmas. I love reading them. I read every single one. But it is starting to get hard. It's that time again where it's really hard to just keep up with answering everything, because by the time I finish editing and uploading and all the filming throughout the day, I really just want to shut my brain off. So if I don't answer a question, please forgive me. It's probably because I've answered it already. I get kind of the same ones over and over, and I will try to mention it in the video. So I think I've been keeping up with them for the most part, but if you have a question and it doesn't get answered, it's probably because I've answered it or I will be addressing it in a video. So thank you so much for all your comments though. I do love reading them. It's just at the end of the night or first thing in the morning when I go through them, I'm just so tired. So also, the makeup that I shared yesterday that I got in the mail, I'm in love with. I used the new concealer, the Dior one. I used it this morning. Amazing. And I also used the blush, and I love it. So two thumbs up for both of those products. And I think I am just going to head out the door so I can get back nice and early, beat the afternoon traffic. I've got something fun I'm going to pick up, and I will share a bit more of that later. I think I am going to get myself out the door, get this errand out of the way so that I beat the afternoon rush of traffic. And then I will come back and do some list making in my Christmas journal, and I will take you along with me. I thought I would give you a little update on the hermit crabs that Camden got for his birthday last year. He still has the three. They are doing really, really well. We love them. They are very low maintenance, and there was even a few months where we barely saw two of them. They've just been burrowing underneath the mulch, and we've actually seen two of them molt. One little guy actually came out of his shell and stayed out of it for a few hours and then found a new shell, and we saw little parts of his claws and things that he had sort of shed. So they're really, really interesting. I was just cleaning out their water dishes and just checking on them, and two of them happen to be out right now. So this guy here is Rashi. This guy here is Douglas. You're probably not going to see them because they get very, very shy. And Jesse, who loves apples, is underneath here. I was just sort of cleaning up and picking out little bits because they drag the cereal and the oats and the apples everywhere. And we've got all the empty shells in this corner here and over here. So if they need any bigger shells, they have a few options. So they're doing really well. I just filled up their water dishes. I'm going to dump this little food dish out and get a fresh little dish of food for them. They love apples, and we give them crab food, but they seem to really like the oats, the apples, little bits of fruit that I can put in there for them. So that's our little hermit crab update. We really, really love them. I just got back from Canadian Tire. I love looking at their holiday decorations, particularly the Christmas tree ornaments. The last few years, I've picked up some really beautiful ones there, and I was hoping to get a couple more, but I don't know what's happening this year. Half of the shelves are empty. They really didn't have many ornaments at all. Most of the good ones are gone. I don't know if they sold out early or if they just didn't get them this year. It was a little disappointing. They have this range called Canvas or Canvas Home, and I really love it. I actually went to get this little outdoor tree for outside. I picked up three of them. Only one of them is for me. Another one is for my sister and my friend next door, because some people on the street are organizing a little bit of an outdoor holiday themed decorating. So I will keep you posted and share that once it all comes to life. I hope it will be very beautiful. But while I was there, I remembered that they carried these kind of Lazy Susan things from the Home Edit. And I've been wanting one for a few spaces in the house. So this is the divided turntable. It has little dividers in here and a little removable thing. You can put it on a shelf or in a cupboard. I love it. It's a big one, so I'm not sure where I'm going to fit that one. But I also got two of these little turntable ones. I love these in the kitchen cabinets. And so I've got two of those to organize some of my spaces in there, because bit of a mess in there. I also picked up a package of these Starbucks Nespresso original pods, because I still have my original machine in the basement, and this is just really good to have just in case I need a super quick cup. And it's not the prettiest, but I got this cheese knife or slicer. I can't seem to find one that I had years ago. And I just thought during Christmas time, if I have any blocks of cheese out and we want to just slice some, this might be really good. And Glenn is always taking chunks off of the huge block of Parmesan cheese. I don't know if this will be great for that, but I thought I could use one of those. So I'm going to have a little look in my kitchen cabinets and see if I can use these two turntables for, I have like sprinkles and little dishes and things that I think this would be really good for. And I might use another one for some tea. And I'm not sure if this one will fit in my kitchen, but if it doesn't, I think it might work in my sewing room too. So either way, I'm pretty sure I can find a use for all of these. I love organizing spaces. You guys probably already know how much I love makeup. Cookbooks, planner supplies, and makeup, they're all my thing. And I know I got that package from Sephora yesterday that had the Dior concealer in it, but I've been on a bit of a Dior makeup kick recently. I have a few things in my collection already that I really, really love, and a few new things have caught my eye. So I had to order them from separate places, so that concealer came yesterday. And around the same time, I ordered a few other pieces from The Bay, which is a big department store here in Canada. It's the Hudson Bay Company. And for some reason, my order has been broken up into pieces and being shipped separately. So the first piece just arrived. I am very excited about it. I love blush. And this is called the Couture Color Longwear Powder Blush. It's actually, I think, a special edition. So this one is the Rouge Blush, the Atelier of Dreams. The color is 601 Hollow Glam. And I know that you can get this color in their regular blush range, but I think the way that they embossed this one is what makes it special. So the color is always available, but this particular packaging may not be. So it comes in this beautiful compact with a little velvet pouch to put it in. I love those. The really big mirror. And here it is. So it has the Atelier embossed into it, or the House of Dior, which is so beautiful. And if you can see, it's got some shimmer and kind of a holographic feel to it. I just thought it would be really, really pretty for the holidays. I did put a swatch here, but it's so sunny that it's a little bit hard to see. I really, really love it. So I'm excited to have this to add to my little makeup collection. And I'm hoping that my next package will come soon, where I have, I think, two more items coming. I just had an afternoon brownie break with Camden. It's just the two of us at home today. James is at school. Camden does his class online, and Glenn is at work today. So it's really quiet. I brought us home lunch. We did a little bit of work together, and we just had leftover brownies, and I made myself a second cup of coffee for the day. And I've had lots of questions about my new machine, the Breville Bambino Plus. I absolutely love it. I find it really easy to use. I think I've mastered the grinder, like grinding the espresso beans. The beans I have are delicious. I'm really happy with those. Pulling the shots, no problem. I think I'm just still mastering frothing the milk, just the settings there. I've just been, I don't know. I need to figure out if I want the temperature higher or not. I don't want to scald it, but I'm not an expert at that. And I did get a lovely little comment with some advice from Laura, who's from Penrose Knits. She has an amazing Vlogmas. If you haven't seen it, you need to check it out. She left a comment in one of my recent videos, just giving me some tips on what to do with the milk after I froth it. I think it was tapping the bottom of it down and giving it a swirl before I pour it in. Definitely helps, but I haven't mastered my latte art yet. That'll come. I don't really care about the art right now, but I'm definitely enjoying it. And I think I'm just going to go and sit down with Camden for a little bit before everyone else gets home. And I'm just having a look at the recipe that I want to make for tonight. It's from the Let Me Feed You cookbook that I shared a few days ago. This one is by Rosie Dakin. It's a beautiful book. And I picked up the ingredients to make this DGM meatloaf. So I've tried many different meatloaf recipes before. I don't know why. It's just one of those things that I always like trying a new one. And I might even make some mashed potatoes to go with it. So it is a nice comforting meal. It is super cold today. It's very, very chilly. And I just feel like meatloaf and mashed potatoes would make everybody happy. And then I'll have some leftovers for lunches with that too. So I'm just making sure I know what time I need to put it in the oven and I have everything ready to get that prepared. And I'm just going to enjoy my coffee until that needs to happen. Chocolate.